And we're going to start this with a slip knot. So cross the rope over itself, bring it through the loop, and then tighten it up. And you don't want the loop to be too huge. And the name of the game for this project is consistency in the loop sizes as we're working along. You want to keep them as close to the same size as possible. And you do need to leave a good size tail so that we can weave this in at the end to hide it. Okay, now all we're going to be doing is just grabbing the yarn, the rope through the chains, now what I am making, traditionally people used this technique, the arm knitting or hand knitting, finger knitting. In other words, you're not using needles or hooks, you're just using your hands. And normally this was done for blankets, giant blankets. And that was probably the first project I saw using this. But I am, for me that's overkill, that's just too much. And of course it's way too expensive. So all I want is something that's going to go at the end of my bed, and I'm calling it a bed runner, like a table runner, but for the bed. So all I need is an 18 inch width, and then I'm going to grow it out to 60 inches long. And of course you can adjust the width and the length to whatever you need. Now to build on to the second row, just grab the yarn, pull it through that last loop, skip that little space right there, which is actually the next chain. We're going to skip that. Can you see that? Okay, so that was the last loop. I went through there. I'm skipping this one, going into the next one. And thereafter, we go through each chain. Okay, so the trick to this is consistency in the loop sizes. Okay, and then you go into the next chain, bring up your loop. Now, if you're a crocheter, you'll know the terms I'm about to use. So, you can keep going across, going through the top of each chain as we're doing, or you can turn this over and go through the back loop or the third loop, as we call it. Turn it over, and you'll see these loops here. So you can go through, pull the yarn, bring it through, and go through each of those loops in the back. So if you're a crocheter, you know what that's going to do if you've done this before. It will actually build a little wall down here. So instead of being flat, like I'm doing here, this will lay flat. This technique, going through the back loops, will stand the project up so that it builds like a little wall. So you can do that for this blanket or whatever you're making. But for me, I didn't want that look. I don't want that little wall. Okay, so I'm not going to do that, but you can. Okay, so we're going to go through each chain. And then this is the last one. You're not going through that knot. Remember that that's the knot at the end. You're not going to go through that. And then just keep going. Go through that last loop. And then the next one. So just be careful that you're not missing any of your loops as you're working along. See, now that one's way, way too big. Pull that back down. Okay, so we're back at the beginning. So just keep going. This material, because it's not yarn, as I keep saying, yarn, not yarn, is actually very pet friendly. So a lot of people use this for pet beds, for a doggy bed. Do cats use beds? I don't know. I don't have any pets. But of course, this is perfect because it's very resilient and hardy. It's soft, as I said at the very beginning, but it's not going to shed or pill, or it's not fragile like the wool blankets are. So this is perfect for pet projects. You know, as I'm talking, I'm going to explain a little something about my hands, okay? Because I know when I play this back and I look at it, all of these veins, I know it's horrible and it's hideous, and I want to apologize, but I can't help it. My hands have actually looked like this since forever. When I was in my 20s, they looked like this because I have these like super skinny hands and fingers. My wedding ring when I was married, I should keep going, a million years ago, was a size 2, and it would fall off of my fingers. I was at the movie theater one time, you know, just sitting watching, and then my ring just like slid right off and just rolled down the aisle, and everybody was, you know, on their feet looking for my wedding ring. But, you know, this happens because there's no fat on my hands. Believe me, I have plenty of fat everywhere else, but okay, TMI, right? Too much information. Okay, so we're just gonna keep going. That's the pattern. See how easy this is? Oh, I also wanted to mention, as long as I'm gabbing away, if you find that, like I did, this yarn is just too expensive, yarn, not yarn, you could wait for Prime Day, Amazon Prime Day. Now, I have no way of knowing just yet if this is going to be on sale, but, and we don't even know if there's going to be a Prime Day for 2020. You know why. So as of the last time I checked a couple days ago, there still was no date set, if at all. Now, word on the street, the Google Street says that October is probably the date, sometime in October, early October. But Amazon hasn't made the announcement yet. But, you know, if you wanted to do this, but it's just too expensive, the yarn, you could do that, you know, hang on for Prime Day, if there is going to be one. Okay, I'm going to keep going here. Okay, I came to the point in my project where I needed to tie on another rope. And all I did was a regular knot, and I did it twice, so I double knotted. If you watch any of my crochet videos, I like knots. A lot of people don't, but for me it's more sturdy, more secure. So when I go to wash this, I don't want it coming apart because of a weak knot. or whatever method you use to join, but I use knots. And it will be hidden on the back side. Now, something I have not mentioned yet is as you are pulling it through, make sure you've got it nice and straight here. You don't want it to cross over or do anything like that. Just make them nice and straight. Okay, we are at the finish line and it is time to cast off. I think that's a knitting term, casting off. Okay, so super easy, just as it has been. So you take that last loop and the one right before it, hold both of them in your hand, pull the yarn through both. Take that last loop, and then the next one, pull the yarn through both. There you go. You end up with a chain at the top. And of course, just bring this through all the way. And then tie it, leave a good size tail. Tighten it to knot it. And then we'll weave through the tail. See, as you're weaving it through, go through one strand in the back. Now I'm coming back in the other direction. Now I'm going to knot it. And then you can cut off that tail there. I would feel more comfortable. I'm going to go back and just sew these with a needle and thread, the little ends. Just tuck that in and sew that little edge there. Just so that this doesn't start pilling and peeling and whatever it does. And that's it. We'll be able to come back and just perfect it all. Lay it down so that it's looking the way you like and straighten out the corners. Tighten it up where you need to. And there you go. Super squishy. Just how I hoped.